Okay, welcome. My name is Dr. Jeffrey Lee, and I hope you are all enjoying our Facebook Lives. And we're really trying to help deliver some content and just to help you keep healthy during this social distancing or quarantine or physical distancing that we're all going through right now. Thank you for joining us. If this is your first time, welcome. And we're getting a lot of emails asking where we're located. So we are a naturopathic clinic in Richmond, British Columbia. And we have been doing this since, I think, March 18th or 19th. So there's a series of videos that we've done. So please check out our website or Facebook and just to see what we've been up to. Today, I'm going to be talking about something that's just a little bit lighter, a little bit more fun. So it's a shorter video, but we're going to be talking about sprouting. And I brought some of my things here, and I'll show you what sprouting is. I invite you to please share these videos to friends and family, and we want to, you know, help as many people as we can. Now, there's also a new schedule that's coming out, and I want to invite you, if you have any kind of health topics that you're interested in learning more, just comment and just let us know. You can always send us an email. That would be fantastic. We want to be, again, relevant, and whatever new topics that you're interested in learning more about, just let us know. I'm also going to be doing a Facebook Live, what we're calling a masterclass. It's just a bit longer, but we're going to be doing that on Saturday, and I'm going to be talking about mental health and the immune system. So we've been getting a lot more requests on just tips for mental health there, and I think that's really important. I've shared in some of my other videos that there's been, some people are having a really hard time, so I'm just always encouraging, let's, as a community, reach out, give our neighbors a call, chat with different people, pick up the phone. We actually were, I think some of my neighbors are listening, but one of my neighbors had an awesome idea. She teaches Zumba, and she was trying to coordinate just sort of a neighborhood sort of Zumba class. We're all on our lawns and doing that. We're postponing that just because I think some of the kids around might not continue to practice the whole social distancing, but I just wanted to just share an idea, get out there and talk to people, interact with people through things like Zoom or Facebook Live. Some people are having a rough time. So this coming weekend on Saturday, I will be talking more about mental health and how it affects the immune system, and I'll try to give some more practical tips there. I'm also back at the office this week. I know some patients have been emailing. I was off for spring break, but I am back in the practice. So if you want to just chat, if you want to, touch base on your health, we are doing that through telemedicine. So just reach out to Annette, and I'm happy to help you. Like I said, today's a little bit more of a fun Facebook Live. We're going to talk about sprouting. And to me, that's a super, super easy way of bringing nutrients in the body. We're trying to provide just simple, practical tips there. I shared a little bit on, I think, March 24th. That was my first Facebook Live. I shared what I'm consuming, what I'm eating in terms of food, and what I'm taking in supplements there to boost my immune system. So I invite you to watch that one. That was on March 24th that I did that. But I'm also wanted to give some practical tips for those of us who just, either can't have supplements, they don't like it, it doesn't work for them, they can't afford it for whatever reason. I thought about sprouting because it is a really inexpensive way that you can get a lot of nutrients there. And if you've been patients of mine for a number of years, you know where I sit, where I don't like to push a lot of supplements on patients there. I'm really trying to target their health through foods. I really believe in the power of foods there. So, what I've had to do is, myself, even in the past, especially couple of weeks there, where I've actually been really strict with my supplement routine, and I've been taking a lot of my vitamin C regularly. I talked about having a more of an alkaline diet there, but I'm also taking a lot of my greens products there. I'm taking my vitamin D there. So this is a time, and I'm just going to say it again, this is a really important time. If you aren't doing so, just find ways of just improving your immune system. Let's get started there. So I've been sprouting for like a number of years there, and when I was preparing for this talk, I just went online and I realized, like, wow, there's a lot more people that are into sprouting or microgreens, and that's really exciting. So all of a sudden, there's a ton of like new products out there. You don't necessarily have to use any of those fancy products there. I'll show you kind of a really simple setup that I do. I did get pretty fancy for a while, where I was doing a lot of microgreens and microgreens. Now, I might be using some older terminology, but my understanding of microgreens is I just had these trays, and I would have the different seeds there, and so and but I would have soil, and I would have a fancy light source and a pretty powerful light source, and I was able to actually grow these little beds of greens there. It looks like grass, so whatever I'm growing. So I did that for a while, and that involves some equipment. It involves some special lights there. I kind of geeked out on that, and I really enjoyed it. But now these days, I'm actually keeping it really, really simple. So I'm just using like a mason jar. I'm soaking some seeds there, so it's really easy, and I'll walk you through that in a moment. But the question is, why is sprouting good? And I'm just going to share 3 points with you why I think sprouting is really good. Number one is sprouting unlocks the nutrients inside a seed. So whether you're going to be sprouting like a broccoli seed, a radish seed, maybe even lentils, like there's a lot of nutrients inside that's packed inside a seed. And when you're sprouting it, you're actually releasing a lot of the enzymes, a lot of vitamins, a lot of minerals, and then definitely a lot of antioxidants there. So it's just so concentrated with nutrients there, and it's such a tiny form factor there, right? It just again. And I'll show this in a bit more detail later there. So number one, it unlocks the nutrients inside a seed. Number two, sprouting makes food way easier to digest as well as absorb. It doesn't irritate the gut. So I have some patients who, they can't eat broccoli or cauliflower because it gives them, a bit too much gas for some reason, or for example. And the sprouting actually breaks down. It's got a lot of enzymes in the sprout, so it breaks down some of those phytochemicals that just don't agree with digestion. So number two, sprouting makes it way easier for you to digest and absorb your foods there. And then lastly, it's a whole food. And I mentioned that whole foods, it's a plant, it keeps the body more alkaline, and the more we have it, the better. Okay, so that's why I sprout, and that's why I think it's really good. Now, how do I eat sprouts there? I put them, into salads. I put them into my soups there. I incorporate them into my stir fry. Sometimes I'll put them into my sandwiches. And it's a great way of just adding texture, some spice to it. And I say spices, when you start doing like things like the radish sprouts, you'll notice, oh, it's got a little bit of a kick to it. So that's what I do for sprouting, and that's how I consume my sprouts there. And sometimes I'll just have them as a snack, so it's actually quite easy to consume. Now, a question that a lot of people ask me, is it safe to sprout? And I think that's a really good question. So, the risk of salmonella and E. coli, yeah, those are real concerns. But however, I think that's much more in like the commercial or the grocery setting. Yeah, unfortunately, if you go to the grocery store and you're buying like alfalfa sprouts and all that, there have been cases of, E. coli contamination. And I believe it's because when you're in like in a large kind of a commercial scale, it's harder to keep things clean, and it's harder to avoid a lot of the bacteria. However, at home, I think sprouting is super, super safe. I've been doing it for, 15, 20 years, and I've never had a problem. I've taught a lot of patients how to sprout, and we've never had any problems there. And I think the reason why, when you're doing it at home, you can keep your equipment really clean. You're in small batches there. So things like mason jars, you can keep that really clean. You can control how frequently you're cleaning, you're rinsing, and you could regulate the airflow. And lastly, you can control the quality of the seeds. If you buy high quality seeds that are from a reputable source, you know that they're free from bacteria there. So there's a lot of ways that you can control and keep it safe. And that's why I think sprouting at home is actually really, really safe. So I mentioned earlier, what are the things that I sprout? I sprout mung beans, radish seeds, alfalfa seeds, chia seeds, broccoli seeds. And I'm just going to show you, I get all my seeds from West Coast Seeds. And West Coast Seeds is, you can order it online, but it's also a Ladner store. Now, I realize that when I'm on Facebook Live and I'm showing something, that the image is reversed there. I can't figure out why yet, but if you can't really see this, it's just a bag of broccoli seeds from West Coast Seeds. And they are an awesome company. I get a lot of my gardening supplies there and a lot of my seeds. I get all my seeds from West Coast Seeds. Now, I'm going to walk you through just the procedure of how I sprout. So what I simply do is I usually will start with a tablespoon or a couple of tablespoons. I will scoop them out of the bag, and then I add them to a really simple mason jar and open it up. It's a very, inexpensive, simple mason jar that you can get at local stores there, a couple of bucks each. And then I'll soak them. I soak my seeds usually, and it depends on what kind of seeds. So actually, if you go to West Coast Seeds or if you Google it, every seed kind of has a chart that shows you how many hours it needs to be soaked. But on average, 4 to 8 hours is usually what I soak my seeds. So that's the first thing that I do. Second is I will rinse those seeds out in this jar, and I rinse it really well, and I drain all the water. And next, I just want to show you that I have these special lids that I use. And if you look closely, they are perforated. So I've been using this one for years, and it's just a simple metal mesh thing that fits in the lid of the mason jar. I've used this for years. More recently on Amazon, I just picked up one of these special sprouting lids, and this is worth getting. It's super... It makes it a lot easier, and there's a little stand on it. So once I finish rinsing my seeds, I will drain everything out. I'll screw this on, and then I'll just place it into a bowl. And I'll place it at an angle where the water can drain out, and then the airflow can get in here because it's perforated. And you can also put this, down, let everything drain out there because there's these little feet here. So I really like a lid like this. And after I've done that, it's in a bowl. It's usually set on an angle. I just tuck it away. I sometimes put it in a really dark spot on my counter, or I'll put it up into a cupboard there, just as long as there's some good airflow there. And that's it. All I do is I just leave it there. So every 12 hours, I'll just rinse it out. I don't even open this anymore. I just take it to the sink. I rinse it about 3-4 times, and then I drain it again. It's as easy as that. It takes me 1, maybe 2 minutes to do that. Actually, not even that. And that's it. And then I set it back into a bowl, and I just let it drain again, and I tuck it away. Now, what you're going to observe is you're going to start seeing that the seed will start, sending off a little shoot there. It's a little bit of a sprout there that it sends out. And you're just going to watch it over the next couple of days. Usually for a good batch, it takes me about 4 or 5 days for me to get this jar from, seeds to... Now, this is only about a tablespoon. If I, after, if I, 2 tablespoons will really fill up this entire jar there. And it takes me about 4 or 5 days of rinsing every 12 hours, as easy as that. And then the last thing that I do is, my last rinse, I'll actually take this and I'll just put it by the windowsill. And I just did this for this morning, for about 3 hours, and it starts greening up. And this is what you want to do. You want to be able to get that photosynthesis, to get the chlorophyll and really activate the sprouts there. So again, before I consume these sprouts, I make sure I get them in front of a window and and get them nice and green. So it's as simple as that. After I do that, I might dry it. I might actually, I'll pour these out maybe onto a paper towel, and I'll let it dry for about 30 minutes, and then I'll clean out that jar, I put it back into the jar, and I'll store it into the fridge. And it's as easy as that. So that's what I just wanted to show you, that the equipment is actually quite minimal. I've picked up all these things. I've picked up the lids on Amazon, or you can go to West Coast Seeds. Mason jars, I just picked them up at Canadian Tire. Again, not very expensive. And then if you want to get more sophisticated, you can search the microgreens, and you can get fancy lighting, and you can really grow a lot. So just a quick story. When I started doing this years ago, I had aquarium lighting, so just fancy T5 lighting. And I built my own kind of rack, and I would have like several trays going out at once. And my neighbors were a little bit suspicious of me, just because they would see every time I would open up my garage, I'm growing some stuff. So I think they were wondering if I was growing like marijuana or something like that. But, I told them, nope, nothing illegal. I'm just growing some sprouts. So I got some of my neighbors, interested in sprouting as well, just kind of watching me. As I'm going to wrap this up, I just wanted to share just a couple of just simple tips there, because when you first start sprouting or doing microgreens, the next day you're going to see like the roots. It looks like they're moldy. You kind of see all these little fine hairs there, and it looks like it's moldy. And when I first noticed that, I thought I was doing something wrong. So that's just a quick tip. Take a closer look. Often it's actually not mold, and it's just the root, the hairs in the root fibers. It just looks like mold there. And then you give it a good rinse there, and you'll realize that, okay, actually it wasn't mold. So now if you're really concerned about like mold or bacteria, just give it a sniff. You'll smell something bad when it starts, decomposing, or if it gets really, really bad, you'll have that odor. So that's just a quick way of testing that. And then lastly, some patients will ask me, like, how long can I keep this in the fridge? How long can I keep the sprouts in the fridge? I usually will try to consume them in about 3 days. And usually I'll have several different seeds going. I'll do kind of a rotation. So every other day I might start some different seeds there. So I'll usually have a constant supply. And sometimes I don't make like a huge batch. So I just want to make sure I'll consume that all in, one or two meals there, or a snack there. So I hope that was helpful. I just want to have a little bit of a fun just showing you a couple of simple things. So that's really easy to boost up your immune system. I know Dr. Karen is going to be, and I think both Dr. Karen and Dr. Neetu, and I think Dr. Vanessa as well, they're probably going to show you some different cooking techniques. I think I saw Dr. Karen's doing some pickling. So again, give us comments, give us some feedback. If there's certain topics that you're interested, we're happy to maybe teach you some different things. So I had fun showing you a couple of these, Sprouting 101, and I look forward to helping you more in the future. Talk to you soon.